Hi everyone, Michael Elliott here, president of Amherst College. I'm between two mammoths, and today I'm with Sarah Wu from the class of 2025. Sarah is the editor-in-chief of The Indicator, the Amherst College student-run literary and arts magazine. She's also an editorial assistant on The Common and a double major in computer science and English. Sarah, thanks so much for being here. Let me start with that combination of computer science and English. That's, you know, from opposite ends of the curriculum in some ways. How do you think about the relationship between your interest in the sciences and computer science and the arts and literature?
CompSci and English both look at the world in a way that is focused on creativity and also interpretation. And some people say that like English and a STEM field are very similar like trains of thoughts for them. But for me, CompSci is very precise because a lot of it is putting it into numbers. And a lot of it is trying to make things come out as accurate as possible. And I think for English, a lot of nuance is possible because you don't have to necessarily say, like, this is the thing that I want to tell you. A lot of it comes from the reader putting in their own experiences and interpreting them the way they want. So I personally think they're very different things. They have like similar methodologies in terms of like trying to figure out the world, but in very different ways.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. So you mentioned creativity a second ago, and right now you're involved in planning for one of our significant expressions of creativity, LitFest, which will take place later in February. How'd you get involved in LitFest, and what's that process of planning been like?
The LitMag that I'm part of, The Common, has a really big role in organizing a lot of the people who come, and that's mainly Jen Acker's duty, and she's the editor-in-chief mm-hmm. of The Common. Me and the rest of the interns of The Common, we kind of hype up LitFest. So we have events such as PreFest. Basically, it's to produce a sort of community around LitFest and get people excited for it.
Now, in addition to that, you are editor-in-chief of The Indicator. Tell me a little bit more about what that experience has been like for you.
Yeah, I'm editor-in-chief with two other amazing people. We wanted to create a space where people of all different experiences could sort of write and share their stories. So the thing about The Indicator is it's not rated on a person's writing. Someone submits and we don't like grade their writing and put them in. It's free for anyone who is interested in writing. So anyone who joins our club actually gets published. And this is really helpful for people who really just want to find a writing community because they're really into writing. They want to find people who are also excited about creating short stories or poetry or art. It's a lot about community building, I think, and a lot about encouraging people to get started in writing.
That's terrific. Well, thanks for all what you're doing to build that kind of community. It really matters, I think, at a place like Amherst. But I'll ask you as a final question, a question that I think every English major gets tired of answering, but is do you have a favorite book or a book that particularly inspires you that you recommend to other people?
Yeah, so I think a book that really inspired me and is also pretty well known. I think the author actually came to one of the readings here, which was really awesome, but her name is Ling Ma, and she wrote a book called Severance, and I think it got really popular after the pandemic hit. Mm-hmm. But I thought it was really cool because it was honestly like a really interesting way of writing sci-fi in a way that's super realistic because it's like set in the modern world, but it's about an event that hasn't happened yet. And it relates a lot back to, I think, how people consider the immigrant experience in terms of like moving over to a new land and feeling very detached from homeland. So it has all these complicated themes. And the world is like perfect to kind of like nurse or nurture that sort of feeling in a unique way. And I was really inspired by her writing style, and the book is great.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Sarah Wu, for being here with us on Between Two Mammoths.
Yeah, it was nice speaking with you.